Hey y'all, welcome to my channel. My name is Vanessa and I'm excited today to do a review and tutorial with the two-faced Tutti Frutti Razzle Dazzle Berry eyeshadow palette. This is what the box looks like, and this is what the palette looks like. I think the packaging is stunning. I love it. It's a little magnetic clasp there, then opens like that. It's got a little raspberry over there, I believe, just like the outside packaging, and there are all of our colors. Now, there's only two mattes. Normally, I'm not attracted to palettes like this, but the color scheme really, really just caught my eye. Okay, guys, so here are the swatches of all the shades in the palette. Clearly, for me, this one right here is the star of the show. It's just gorgeous. But it retails for $34, and I believe I did say that there is another one, but it's more of a neutral palette, and this one just for some reason just called my name. So I hope you guys subscribe, and I hope you enjoy this video, and let's just get into it. All right, we are first going to start out with this shade right here, and I'm taking my NYX 16 brush, and I'm first just going to kind of dab this on all the way from inner to outer, and then start blending. A lot of this shade gets covered up, so it really does not have to be perfect. You just want to make sure you get the color down. And this is actually super, super quick. I don't know how that is, because it looks pretty complex, but it's not. And then we're going to go in with the other matte, which is this purple here. And this is a Morphe natural hair brush. It does not have a name, and I'm doing the same thing. The reason that I'm stamping this down is because I put instant age rewind on my eyes, but I didn't set it. I've been trying that here lately. I'm not sure which way I like better. Blending is definitely better if you blend like I do. A lot of people do. It's definitely better setting it with a powder first, but we're going to do it this way today just to make sure that these colors really, really pop. So I set it down and then I blend. So stamp, blend. And a lot of this is going to get covered up anyway. So I guess that's why it's so quick, is because you're not sitting here blending for 3.5 hours. Now, we're going to go in with the fun part. This is an Eco Tools little double-ended brush. We're using this side. And we are going in with this. This is a really, really deep purple black with shimmer. Like, it's got glitter in it. I don't normally like shades like that, but this one we are going to put on. Same thing. Just stamp it on. It does not have to be perfect. And then up here, I'm actually going to bring it into the crease a little bit and round it out all the way around the eye. Don't worry, don't worry. This will come together. And then I'm going to grab concealer again. Throw some on the back of my hand. And I'm using just a flat-ish synthetic brush. This one I got from Walmart years ago. I'm going to put that right in the middle of my eye. And I want to bring it up over the fold there. And then these edges, I'm just gently... I don't know if you'd call that blending, but I'm just gently pulling them out. So that way, these edges won't be harsh. And this shade here is what I was really, really drawn to, but I do love this shade, but this is what we're doing today. And I'm gonna use my finger, and this feels wet to the touch. Like, it's very, very metallic. Like, I mean, very metallic. And I'm just stamping that everywhere that we put the concealer. Just like that. Then I'm going to grab that same brush. And I'm actually going to go in with this purple here on the end. Get a little bit of it on the side of my brush. My voice is jacked up today. I'm so sorry. And right where these two shades meet, I'm just going to blend those together a little bit. I went a different direction than I initially thought that I would. Thought that I would. What? I went a different direction than I initially thought that I would. And so this is the look that I will be going to pick up my son from school in. All right, now we are going to grab that Morphe brush again and go in with this matte purple again. And I'm dipping straight in. And then ever so gently, I'm putting this right on the edge of where the shimmers are stopping. Back in with our NYX brush and our first transition shade. And we're just gonna lightly blend everything again. All right, I have a makeup wipe here. I got more fallout on this side than I did this side. We are just going to wipe all of this up and clean our edge up a little bit. For some reason, when I clean up my edge over here, I don't know if it's where I'm using my left hand or what, but I always have more issue. Like, I always take it up too far. It's not so bad today. And then I'm just going to pat along the edge right here. Like, see, this one's going out this way more and this one's going up more. That's okay. We'll fix that in a little bit. So I'm going to go off camera, do my face and all that. I'll be right back. We're going to finish up this lower lash line. And I actually want to use this purple. So I am going to grab my Eco Tools brush, the one that I used with the other shimmer shades. And I am going to use the side of it. And you can't see that. And dip it in there, and I'm gonna see what this looks like first. Run it straight underneath there. All right, I'm gonna wet my brush with a little bit of Fix Plus and see if this works any better. That did a little bit better, but still not like I want. There we go. Building it up, it looks a lot better. So I'm going to take the first transition shade that we used and blend that right underneath there. Yes. I like it. I like it. We're going to go in with this shade right here for our highlight and just put that right on the inner corners. So I'm going to throw a little bit of mascara on my lower lash line. And we are done. I really, really like this look. I like the way that it turned out. Everything blended nicely, super pigmented. The palette is $34. There's not that many shades, but I think the formula is really, really good. So I would definitely, definitely recommend it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. And if you did, please subscribe. And I hope to see you in my next one. Bye, guys.